हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। होप आई एम ऑडिबल टू एवरीवन। इन दिस वेबिनार वी विल लाइक लर्न माय प्रेफरेंसेस। वी विल कंपेयर टू एक्ट्स ओवर टू डिफरेंट पीरियड्स, टैक्सोनॉमी, इंटीग्रेटेड साइटेशन एनालिसिस, हाउ टू क्रिएट फोल्डर्स एंड सेव द डॉक्यूमेंट फ्रॉम मनुपत्र जजमेंट। वी कैन ऑल्सो सी यूटिलिटी ऑफ साइटेड इन पैरा, इम्पोर्टेंट पैराग्राफ ऑफ दी सुप्रीम कोर्ट जजमेंट्स, एंड हाउ वी कैन यूटिलाइज स्टिकी नोट्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, मनुपत्र is pioneer in online legal research in India since 2001. Is India's premier legal information resource. It is the largest content aggregator of Indian and international materials, linking primary information, secondary material, and analytical content. The company started operation in the year 2000 and launched its flagship product like online database manupatra.com in August 2001. Manupatra is driven by natural language processing, analytics, artificial intelligence, visualization tools, extensive hyperlinking to the judgments, acts, rules, and notification circulars. Overtalls are basically still on rudimentary search, but we are a hardcore research tool and not a tool to take only a printouts. First of all, to access Manupatra, we can log in with our ID and password. Just click on this link. It will log in to the database. Now we can see in the left side a table of content. When we click on a plus sign, it will expand the database. We have Supreme Court judgments from 1950, Supreme Court orders we have from 1980. Apart from Supreme Court judgments, the High Courts database from 1860 onwards, and you can see the other courts also. The Federal Court, the old High Courts, Kutch, Lahore, Nagpur, or Peshawar, Privy Council judgments. Apart from Supreme Court and High Court judgments, we are covering tribunals and commissions orders. For example, these are the tribunals: Appellate Tribunal for Electricity, Appellate Tribunal for Foreign Exchange. We have CAT orders for all the branches. We are also covering Competition Commission of India's order, Seagate and State Compact, Cyber Appellate Tribunal, also covering DRT and DRAT orders, Employees Provident Fund and Appellate Tribunals orders, Industrial Court orders, ITAT orders, so NCDRC with the state consumer dispute, all the states you can see. Apart from these tribunals, we are also covering NCLT orders, NCLAT, National Green Tribunals, Real Estate Regulatory Authority Orders, Trademark Registries. These are the tribunals we are covering. Next is International Database. We are covering US, UK, Sri Lanka, South Africa, Singapore, Pakistan, New Zealand, International Court of Justice, Court of Justice for the European Communities, judgments from Australia, Bangladesh, Canada, Hong Kong. Recently, we have added English report from 1222 1873, maritime cases from 1872 1940. Apart from judgments, we have subject wise informations on different subjects under the business and policy. So Manupatra is divided into two parts. One is from a legal side and another part is a business and policy. So under the business and policy, you can get A to Z information related to that particular subject. When we click on the table of content, it will give you the introduction, background, Indian arbitration. For example, we have taken arbitration as an example, international arbitration, articles for that particular subject, treaties for that particular subject. The same way we can also covering the WTO, anti-dumping, capital market. You can see the table of content, which are the acts, rules, regulations, schemes, guidelines, bills. So these are the information for that particular subject. The same way we are covering competition law, consumer law, corporate laws, for example, table of content. Now we want to see the due date and penalties. We can see due date and penalties from here. Resolutions, what are there? Month-wise compliance chart. Annual reports, information of Indian accounting standard, LLP details, secretarial standards. The same way we are also covering the consumer law, corp, cyber IT law. Under the IPR, we can see information related to IPR. We have international cases of IPR. Subject wise, you can see like patent cases, copyright case, trademark case. These are the cases, WIPO cases. IPR notifications are there. We have separate articles on IPR. Now, the same way we are providing the information related to employment laws, forex banking, industrial Indian industrial policy, human rights, foreign trade, environment, insolvency, insurance, and the other parties like corporate law and taxation. We can see the direct taxation, indirect taxation. Same way we can identify the statutes, rules for that particular subject, notifications, circulars, CBDT guidelines for that, redirector on direct tax, other relevant information for that particular subject, committee reports are there. Same way we are giving information for indirect taxation. We have information on GST and VAT also. So apart from business and policy, we are covering notification circulars for central and state. So when we click on this link, it will expand into four domain. These notification circulars from 2020, you can see the old notification circulars also. When we click on this link, you can see the ministry wise details. When we click on link, and if you want to open a RBI notification for bankers, when we click on 2019, it will give you the list of the notification circulars with the description. So when we open the notification circulars, you can see which notifications referred in this particular notifications. If we want to see whether that particular notification referred in any case, you can click on referred in. You can see citing reference also. This particular notification referred in this particular notification. So all are the hyperlinked. When we click on this link, it will open that particular notification. So these are the notification circulars for central. When we click on the state, you can see the state notification circulars also. Now we have central act and local acts of the states. When we click on the plus sign, expand to the BARE Act, you can see table of content. You can see BARE Act in a five different way. Like you can see alphabetically, chronological, subject wise, ministry wise, and industry wise. Now I want to identify the acts for FMCG Just I will click on the industry wise and select the FMCG. So you can see the result for the FMCG industry. The same way I want to identify by the ministry wise. So Ministry of Power, which are the acts related to Ministry of Power. These are the acts related to Ministry of Power. Now I want to see a subject wise. For example, I want to see mines and minerals. So which are the acts related to mines and minerals. So we click on this link and it will open the list of the acts. You can see acts alphabetically. So you can see A to Z. Now we can see the different icons next to that particular acts. Now, for example, if we take a Aadhaar Act and we see the first one is Act in a different language. Now we can see this particular act in a Hindi also. The same way, the next button is brief facts. You can see the statement of objective, date of assent, list of the amending acts for that particular act. We can see the rules for that particular act. When we click on this link, it will list rules for the Aadhaar Act, regulations, orders. Just click on the back to TOC. The next icon is annotations, brief information, section wise information you can get it for that particular act, why that particular act introduced, what is the utility of this act. So you can see the annotations for that particular section wise. Now, if you want to download this particular act, we can use this button, View Act in a Single Document. So when we click on this particular link, it will open full act in a single window. In a continuous, you can see different sections. If you want to download, if you are using Chrome, then you can just click on this print button. And you can see the save as a PDF option. Just save, you can offline, you can save this particular act. We have divided the acts into different parts. Like this particular act is having more sections. Like we have divided 1 to 35 into one part, and after section 36 to end of this particular section 59 in a second part. You can just click on this link and save this particular part also. Now we want to search judgment directly from this particular Barrett. For that we can use, for example, I want to search judgments on Administrative Tribunal Act on section 9. For example, I just click on this act title. Sorry. Just select the Administrative Tribunal Act 1985 and you can see the section 9. When we click on this section 9, it will give you the text of that particular section. You can see the digest over here. When we click on the judgments, it will give you the digest for that particular section also. When we click on the Supreme Court or High Court, you can identify the judgments also. So these are the selective judgments for the particular section 9. Now I want to search in a Manupatra database. For that we can see this particular link next to the blue link. It will open judgment on section 9. When we click on this link, it will directly go to the Manu search and it will search for the judgments. We can sort the results by cited most, which are the most cited judgments for that particular section. We can sort like this. Now again we'll go to the table of content. This is, we are looking only the Barrett right now. will come with the citation search and cited most in the next part. We can also identify the repeal acts. We can see the amending acts alphabetically, chronological wise. Now we want to identify which are the acts for 2019. You can see the blue flag. It means, for example, code on wages. So it means this particular act still not enforced, yet to be enforced. So when we move cursor on that particular flag, it will give you the detail also, what is the meaning of that, what is the use of this particular flag. Also, we can see the compare chart for Consumer Protection Act. Now, Consumer Protection Act of 1986, which are the new sections implemented in 2019, what is the old act is saying and what is the new. So this is the comparative chart for consumer. By clicking on this link, it will open the comparative chart. The same way you can identify the rules. When we click on the rules, it will give you the alphabetically options. Now, for example, I want to open the drugs and cosmetic rule. Drug, just I'll search. So I can see all the rules for that particular act. Drugs and Cosmetic Act 1940. We can see the main rule also, Drugs and Cosmetic Rule 1945. And the amendments rules. Under the rules, you can also identify the regulations. So these are the regulations we are covering. Orders, schemes, directions and guidelines and procedures. The same way we can browse the BAREC for a state wise. For example, we want to see act for the Maharashtra. Just click on the Maharashtra and table of content. It will give you the list of the acts. When we click on the M, it will open the act, start with the M. These are the acts for the Maharashtra local acts. Apart from BAREC, we have committee reports, assembly debates, under the bills, draft ordinance, sample drafts and agreements, pending bills, stamp duty, court fees and court forms are there, court rules. First, I'll go to the committee reports and click on the table of content. It will give you the index for assembly debates. First is assembly debates. Just click on the link. It will give you the all the volumes here. Next to assembly debates, you can see the law commission reports and other reports also. The criminal law, there are like so many reports are there. So Justice Verma report on a rape law in for 2013. Same way we can identify the court fees for state wise, court forms. So court rules, sample drafts and agreements. These are the subject-wise drafts and agreements are there. For example, dishonor of checks. So these are the precedents. We can also see the commentary. Next to draft agreements, you can see the bills in parliament and ordinance. Bills introduced. When we click on this link, chronological, it will give you the bills for 2019. We can identify the bill number and when it introduced in 2019, objective and purpose. So introduced in the Lok Sabha on 5th July 2019, passed by the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, and the assent date, and the act number, and the year. First link is like as introduced in Lok Sabha, you can see in a Hindi version also, Hindi language, as passed by the Lok Sabha and as passed by the both the houses. We do create the summary for the bills. When we click on the link, it will give you the summary, the bill summary, you can say. Next one is ordinance. Central and state ordinance are there. You can browse the ordinance by year. So these are the ordinance. You can also identify the stamp duty state wise. You can select the state and see the stamp duty. The same way you can also identify suit violation for state wise. With the Central Act and Local Acts, there are some rules and rules like with these statutory forms. So we can identify those forms under the forms. Just click on the statutory forms. It will give you the subject wise detail. When we click on this link, for example, corporate, so it will give you the acts. When we click on this particular act, Companies Act, so you can identify those rules. And for example, Companies Winding Up Rules 2020. So these are the forms which are related to with that particular rules. Under the miscellaneous, you can also see the budget information, economic survey, circle rates, national cases in news, international cases in news. So these are the under the miscellaneous. State of Maharashtra versus Salman Khan for idea cylinder. These are the news. Next to miscellaneous is the e-books. For example, a handbook on real estate investment. So this is the e-book. Same way, you can see academic e-books are there. Click on this link. For CPC, we have linked Manu citation also. So you can directly click on this link. It will open that particular judgment. We can also see the articles. Articles by the students, article by professionals, academic journals, which we have subscribed, newsletters from different law firms, case studies and briefs, mood memorials are there. Alert, press release, and insight informations are there. To search articles, you can search by year of publication, just 2020, and you can see the articles. You can see the author name, subject, and the article by student. It's a newsletter from law firm, subject environment. So same way, you can also send your articles at manupatra.com for publishing. Legal taxonomy is one type of digest. In this webinar, we will take this particular topic also. So first start with the taxonomy, then we will go to the my preferences and the compare of two acts over two different periods. So what is the taxonomy basically? It's a one type of digest. You can see the topics. For example, we'll go for the Civil Procedure Code. Now, I want to identify. When we click on this plus link, it will give you the subtopics under the appeal. Now, appeal from original decree, you can directly go for the judgments. When we see this link, it will open the judgment for appeal from the original site. Now I want to see more topic on appeal from orders. So I just click on the plus sign. Now, these are the different topic. Now I want to identify judgments when appeal lie to the Supreme Court. So when we click on this link, it will open the judgment. So digest will give you the list of the cases. The same way we can take the different subjects also, Constitution of India, for example, the fundamental duties, the scope for that fundamental duties, we can identify that judgment on that particular topic. The same way different subjects are there, this is criminal procedure, direct taxation, Hindu law, law of marriage, joint family and tax law, IPC is there, insolvency is there, IPR is there. So these are the acts which we have covered, law of bail, evidence, limitation, slim law. So you can identify the topics, you can identify the keywords also from this particular taxonomy, and you can identify some judgments. Now we'll start with the my preferences. My preferences will be on my home page. Under the profile you can see the my preferences. So what is the utility of my preferences? Like, you can set default preferences for your search results. For example, if you are searching for anything in through Manu search or legal search, you can, you want to like set default sort results by the decision date newest. So you can, you want to identify the latest judgment first. So you can sort results by decision date. Also, you can enable the synonym preferences. For example, if I search for a particular word, for example, a murder, then it will search for the synonym word is like kill, killing, culpable homicide, or it will also search for section 302 IPC. So when we click on the this particular link, it will search synonyms words also. So navigator preferences, like you want to filter, you want to reduce some filter options, then you can just click on the click to the view references. Now we can make default, like for example, I want to what result by decision date newest. Dictionary link preferences, this is recently we have added. You can also see the word meaning from the judgment, and also we have highlighted some keywords which will be highlighted in a blue font, and those are the fonts for the Supreme Court judgments. Those are the dictionary link preferences. So it will, so the definition of that particular word, we can also tick mark this particular thing for a synonyms. Under the navigator preferences, if you don't want filter option for a industry wise or department wise, you can uncheck this particular thing. So when you search for any particular keyword, it will not give you the result by department or industry wise. Again, we will go to the my home. Under the compare provision, you can see the laws on present date and date of inception. Now we will start with the second topic, comparison of law over two different period. So when we click on this link, it will give you the act wise comparatively chart. We can select any particular act, for example, Electricity Act 2003. When we click on this link, go, it will compare with the Indian Electricity Act 1910, 1948 and 1998. So all the acts are there. You can identify which are the new sections introduced in 2003, which are the old sections are there. So this is the best way to compare old acts over two different periods. The same way we can select the for example design act, it will give you the Design Act 1911 compared with the Design Act 2000. So identify which are the new sections, which are the old sections. Section 9 is certificate of registration, and section 45 for the old act, that is also for the certificate of registration. So you can identify which are the sections. Now we will start another topic, is integrated citation analysis. First, citation analysis, we can search, we can click on the citation search, then you can see the Indian citation and the international citation. Manupatra is like covering around 316 journals, 336 journals across India. The other publishers who is publishing the same judgment, equivalent citations, you can say the same judgments, you can identify by through citation search. Now I want to search one judgment which is published in AIR 2009, the year of 2009, judgment of Supreme Court, and page number is 1059. So I'll just select the publisher. This is AIR Supreme Court. Just select the AIR Supreme Court. I'll just type the year 2009. These two fields are like compulsory, publisher and year. Also, we can give the page number 1059 and just click on the search. So it will open that particular citation. So we can see the equivalent citations, AIR 2009, Supreme Court 1059. The same judgment published by SCC, Scale, RCR, Judgment Today, Supplementary Criminal, ALD, ACR. So apart from all the journals, we are, apart like in India, we are covering 336 journals for the citation search. The next one is like international citation search. We can also see the journal titles. We covered all England law reports for different digest, reprint editions, appellate division. So these are the England and Wales cases, case law, admin, civil, commercial and criminal, Queen's Bench division. So these are the publishers we are covering. The same way we have to search, we can select the publisher, enter the year, page number, volume number and select the code. Now I'll search for one judgment and I'll see you show you the citing reference. For that, for example, so I'll open this particular first judgment of 2005. So I'll show you the citing reference. So I'm talking about this particular citing reference. So what is the citing reference mean? Like when this particular case has been like decided, at that time there are some cases which are referred in this judgment. So we can identify which are the cases relied in this judgment, or which are the cases discuss in this particular judgment, or which are those cases which are just mentioned in this judgment. So when we click on this link, it will open all the name. We can see P. Anand relied in this SBP and versus Patel Engineering, which are those cases. These are the cases which are discussed in this particular case, and these are the cases which are mentioned in the this particular case. So like this we can use the citing reference. Now the next one is Manu Instant. So what is Manu Instant exactly? It will give you the treatment of this particular judgment. Now citing reference is the other thing, is like this citing reference, those are the judgments which are referred in SBB and company, and Manu Cite will give you the treatment of SBB and company. where that particular case has been referred after 2005. So this particular case cited in Manupatra 842 times, last cited on 13th March 2020. So out of 842, there are 50% cases which are where that particular case has been discussed. 33% cases are there where SBP mentioned, 10% relied on. You can see the 4% is distinguished. So SBP and Patel versus Patel Engineering distinguished in 4% cases. We can see the 2% dissented and 1% is affirmed. To identify those cases, we can use this green button that is called an authority check. In this webinar, we have to go for the Manu site. The same way, we can use Manu site for citing reference also. So in the top next to assisted search, you can see this Manu site link. When we click on this link, it will give you the citing reference judgments of for SBP and versus Patel Engineering. So when we click on this link, it will give you the treatment of Wellington Associates Limited versus Kirti Mehta. So cited in Manupatra 120 plus times, what are the treatment for that Wellington Associates Limited, right? Now, we want to now we will take another topic is cited in para. So it is very useful nowadays. You want to identify where this particular case has been referred. So when we click on this link, it will open the cited in para. You can see all the judgments where SBP versus Patel Engineering referred. You can see the list of the cases. When we click on the plus sign, it will give you the exact paragraph number where that particular case has been referred. For example, we'll take Meera Goyal versus Preeti Saraf. You can see the paragraph number 15 of Meera Goyal versus Preeti Saraf. You can also see by placing reliance on the decision of Supreme Court judgment in SBP versus Patel Engineering. So you can see this particular text. You can identify on which topic discussion is going on in Meera Goyal case for the SBP versus Patel Engineering. The same way you can identify the different judgments. For that, we have to click on the cited in para and we have to click on the plus sign. So it will give you the exact paragraph number where that particular case has been referred. If it is it referred in different two or three paragraphs, also you can see different paragraphs. You can directly see the paragraph. Now the next topic is like important para. Now important para is different from the cited in para. Important para is like it will give you the list of the paragraph of SBP and company, which are the paragraph referred in the Supreme Court judgments. How many times that particular paragraph referred or quoted in different cases. So when we click on this link, it will give you the important paragraph of that particular case. So we can see under the case map, you can see the paragraph title. When we click on this link, it will give you the exact para of SBP and versus Patel Engineering. You can see the 5-digit next to that particular para. It means this paragraph referred in 5 different cases. So we can see the list of the cases below that particular paragraph detail. So when we click on the link of that particular case, it will take you to a to that particular paragraph where that particular para referred in this particular case. The same way you can also see which are the other paragraph referred in other judgments. So like this, you can use the important paragraph, M para, you can say. Now the next topic is like create folder. On the top you can see the save this document. When we click on this link, it will ask you to save the document in folder. You can create your own folder. If you are law student, then you can also create folder, and you can also protect with the password. When law students are like use different computers in the library or in the computer lab, so if you want to protect your folder, then you can also give your password. You can select the folder, or you can create your own folder. I'll select my folder. For example, I'll select the Consti one and the click on the save button. So now it will save this particular judgment in this particular folder. You can also browse that particular judgments by clicking on my save document. You can select your folder, then you can see your judgments, your saved judgments. Now we have the last topic is sticky notes. So how you can utilize sticky notes in a lockdown period also. Lockdown period. Nowadays, yeah, you all are working from home. You have your like, for example, you have cases you have to read, and you have to identify the judgments. Now you can create your own index for that particular case, or you can also make index by topic wise. For example, I want to search for particular case. Example, it's a winding up. Now I can identify Supreme Court judgments. I just filter by the court. Now I'll select this particular case. I'll open this judgment in a new window. By clicking on this link, it will open document in a new window. Now I'm reading this judgment, and I have identified like paragraph number 3 is very much important for my particular case of insolvency. So I just want to highlight that particular paragraph. So for that, I can use the sticky note option. So when we click on the enable sticky note, and I'll select that particular paragraph number 3 is there. First of all, you have to click on this link, add highlight. Then you have to select the paragraph to highlight that particular paragraph. Now I want to add comments, like why it is useful, or on what point of law decided, or what point of law described in the particular paragraph. For that, we can use this comment button. Just click on the single click and click in the end of the paragraph, the same simple click, and just click right click. Then you can see the topics. You can create your own topic, or you can create a client name also through client name. For example, my client name is client 89. I've just saved this particular topic, and I'll again select this topic. So now I am under to client 89. Now I'll give you the title of this particular paragraph. For example, it is related to सेवन ऑफ आईबीसी. नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू गिव डिटेल इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट दिस पर्टिकुलर पैराग्राफ और पॉइंट ऑफ लॉ. सो एडमिटिंग अ वाइंडिंग अप एंड आई विल जस्ट सेव दिस पर्टिकुलर डिटेल. नाउ आई कैन सेव दिस जजमेंट इन माई फोल्डर. I'll select my folder, for example, consti, and the save file. So now this particular highlighted para it saved on the judgment, and also the comments also save. Now how can you create the index? In the sticky note, you can see the sticky note summary. So when we click on this link, we can see all the topics over here. We can search by the topic also, and we can select our topic. For example, client 89. So now we can see the section 7 of IBC is there. We can see the party's name, appellant versus respondent. We can see highlighted para over here, and we can see our comments of that particular paragraph also. Right? The same way, we can also add another judgments, a different judgments, and we can save the same way. For example, I want to save this particular Goa State Cooperative. I just open this judgment and I have identified that paragraph number 4 is very much relevant for winding up. So I want to add a note, and I want to add this particular paragraph. The same procedure I can do. For example, 4 and 5 both is important. So I just select 4 and 5. I just add comment. Select my client name for sorry. Select my client name. I just give a title. It's for example, cooperative society. Winding up, confirm, and I'll just save this particular detail. Now I'll go to my citation summary. Now I can see both the judgments under the client 89. You can also take a printout and you can put that printout in your file. You can also mail this particular judgments to your boss or to the to anyone. You can directly click on this send mail. You can give email address of that particular. When you click on the PDF, it will convert into PDF. Now you can see the client 89 file says there is two judges. There are two judgments, section 7 of IBC. Jignesh Shah versus so and so, and the another one is on topic is cooperative society, and the winding up confirm. This particular paragraph says winding up confirm. The same like this, you can create the sticky note. Also create you can create the notes on the judgments. For example, I want to create my own notes on. We can see key points of the judgments you can create through My Notepad. Under the citation search, you can see the My Notepad link. When we click on the Add to My Notepad, you can give the title. You can write key points of the judgments. And you can just submit. Now, whenever you open the judgment, like if we have searched for the winding up, but if we have searched for any particular section, for example, Companies Act and Section 10(e)(1), and you can see the result of Jaipur Metal versus Jaipur Metal. And when you open this particular case, you can see the note on the particular judgment. So you can identify on which point of law this particular case has been referred or decided. You can also share this particular note to anyone. Now, one thing is like pending, the cited most thing. So when we search for particular keyword, for example, arbitration. Now I want to search Supreme Court judgments. I want to search only for the Supreme Court judgments and which are the landmark judgments or which are the most cited judgments for that particular topic which we have searched under the Manu search. So when we click on the sort by cited most, you can see which are the cases has been cited most in other cases. You can sort the results by like this. You can also without login, you can also see the articles. You can also see the training videos, how to use videos are there. If you have any query, you can write a mail to contact@manupatra.com and you can give a subject like webinar on this particular date. And if you have any query, you can send your query also. And if you have any query, you can raise your hand. Hello. Yes, Rajesh.
हेलो, आपका आवाज आ रहा है?
यस यस।
सो मुझे आपको ये पूछना था ना कि अगर सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने जजमेंट पास किया, जैसे कि टाटा और रिलायंस का दोनों का सिमिलर मैटर था, सो
मैंने आपको रिप्लाई किया।
सो आप एक बार उसको बता सकते हैं वैसा करके?
यू कैन गो टू द लीगल सर्च एंड यू कैन फॉर एग्जांपल व्हाट इज टाटा
हेलो आपका आवाज नहीं आ रहा
है यू वांट टू सर्च फॉर टाटा एंड रिलायंस बोथ
नो नो आई जस्ट वांट टू सर्च फॉर रिलायंस लाइक अभी रिलायंस का सिर्फ अपील नंबर दिया है उस पे बट नाम टाटा का है सो वही जजमेंट में सिर्फ रिलायंस का एक समझ लीजिए एक पार्ट में सिर्फ रिलायंस का अपील नंबर के साथ उसका है बट उसका नाम भी नहीं है सो मुझे वो पर्टिकुलर रिलायंस का केस लॉ कैसे मिलेगा
तो आप अपीलेंट एंड रेस्पोंडेंट पे रिलायंस वर्ड डाल देंगे और सर्च पे क्लिक करेंगे तो रिलायंस के सारे जजमेंट्स आपको मिल जाएंगे अगर आपको अपील नंबर अगर आपके पास है तो लीगल सर्च में
नहीं नहीं वही बोल रहा हूँ कि अभी कैसा अपील नंबर मेरे पास नहीं है बट मुझे पता है कि ऐसा कुछ हुआ है मतलब ऐसा कुछ चेंजेस आए पर ना तो मेरे पास अपील नंबर है अगर मैं रिलायंस का डाला भी बट नहीं आ रहा है बिकॉज ऑफ टाटा के नाम पे और उन लोग ने वही सिंगल जजमेंट में उन्होंने कर दिया सो उसके लिए मैं कैसे रिलायंस का मिलेगा कि मतलब
पहले सर्च करना है देन उसको आप टाटा से रिफाइन करके देख लीजिए
ओके
रिलायंस से उसको सर्च कीजिए और फिर उसमें सर्च इन रिजल्ट्स में आप टाटा वर्ड्स को रिफाइन कर लीजिए और अगर वो सुप्रीम कोर्ट का है तो फिल्टर में जाके आप सुप्रीम कोर्ट सिलेक्ट कर लीजिए तो आपको सुप्रीम कोर्ट के 12 जजमेंट्स दिख जाएंगे उसको अगर आप केसेस में देखना चाहते हैं तो डिसीजन डेट यूएस पे क्लिक करेंगे तो आपको उस हिसाब से मिल जाएगा
ओके
भी आपको कोई भी क्वेरी होती है नहीं मिलता है या कुछ भी है तो आप इस जजमेंट पढ़ रहे हैं और उसमें रेफरेंस लिखा है वो जजमेंट का रेफरेंस आप contact@manupatra.com पे आप मेल कर दीजिए और सब्जेक्ट लाइन में आप वेबिनार का रेफरेंस डालिएगा आज की डेट के साथ
ओके ठीक है थैंक यू
यस सुहास हेलो,
हेलो
यस सुहास,
सर, हाउ टू सर्च द नॉन रिपोर्टेड जजमेंट्स? एनी लिंक इज देयर?
नॉन रिपोर्टेड जजमेंट्स लाइक मनुपत्र इज टेकिंग जजमेंट्स, ऑल द जजमेंट्स लाइक
ओके
इफ पब्लिशर इज पब्लिश एनी पर्टिकुलर के जजमेंट इन दैट पर्टिकुलर जर्नल, देन वी
ओके
गिव क्रॉस रेफरेंस ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर केस.
ओके
सो इफ
ओके
सर्च फॉर एनी पर्टिकुलर केस थ्रू सर्च और लीगल सर्च, यू कैन सी ऑल द रिजल्ट. बट इफ यू फाइंड आउट व्हेन वी गो टू द इक्विवेलेंट साइटेशंस, लाइक वी गो टू द मनु साइटेशंस, एंड इफ यू डोंट फाइंड एनी पर्टिकुलर एनी जर्नल इन द लिस्ट, देन इट मीन्स इट्स नॉट रिपोर्टेड इन एनी केस एनी जर्नल.
ओके ओके थैंक यू.
यस मैत्री, यस मैत्री, इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन यू कैन राइट अ मेल टू कॉन्टेक्ट एट मनुपात्रा डॉट कॉम. टाइमिंग्स आर लाइक वी विल क्लोज एट 4:30. यू कैन सेंड अ मेल विद द सब्जेक्ट लाइन वेबिनार एंड डेट ऑफ द वेबिनार एंड योर क्वेश्चन एंड रिप्लाई ऑन दैट. यस लक्ष्मीकांत,
हेलो.
यस लक्ष्मीकांत,
या माय क्वेश्चन इज लाइक व्हेन यू सेव द फोल्डर, सो विल एडिट ऑप्शन, सो सेव द डॉक्यूमेंट व्हेन यू सेव, लाइक वंस यू क्रिएट अ फोल्डर देन देयर इज नो एडिट ऑप्शन, सो इज दैट ऑप्शन अवेलेबल और वी हैव टू
डाउनलोड लाइक अंडर द फोल्डर. इफ यू वांट टू मूव your file, you can select the that particular file and you can move to any other folder.
Okay, that's the only option. So yeah, we cannot edit the main folder name. So by mistake, if I type something and then I have
yeah,
saved
you
all documents,
that particular folder and you create the new folder. And if there are so many files in the judgments in the folder, then you can write a mail to contact at manupatra.com. We will change the name.
Okay, that's fine. So, and one more thing is that, like, apart from adding the notes in that particular judgment itself, so is there any option like whatever notes we make, can we upload that notes so that that will be attached to that judgment somewhere as an additional notes or document something?
Acha, you want to add your own notes on the judgment?
Yeah. So. Yeah, there is a notes which I you explained it very well. So there
yeah.
is notes and stick option.
Yeah, yeah.
But yeah.
Do one thing, you yeah. you have a very big file, then you cannot upload in the on the judgment. If you have short file, then you can copy that content and just go to the My Notepad and you paste under the My Notepad. Then it will give you the content.
Okay, yeah, and like how we can see that in the sticky notes, so that way can we see the same thing for the notepad also, like what all we have done in the notes of the judgment?
Under the My Notepad, you can see the titles only, and you can
okay.
search by the title as of now.
Oh, okay, fine. Thank
the
you.
Sticky note
Thanks.
Will give you the index. Right.
Yeah. Right. That is in detail. So
yeah,
more detail. Yeah. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Yeah. So we will close our webinar for today. If you have any query, you can write a mail to contact@manupatra.com with the subject line of today's webinar if you have any queries. Thank you for